Hi everybody, DK here. Join me as today we take a visit to one of the GTA's oldest Asian-centric shopping plazas. It's become a very popular hangout place for all ages, First Markham Place. Let's check it out. The mall opened in around 1998, roughly about a year after Pacific Mall opened. It actually coincided with a time whereby the large influx of Asian immigrants into the GTA necessitated a demand for more Asian-centric shopping areas and retail spaces.
I've been visiting First Markham Place, I would say over 10, 15 years. We typically come here for cheap eats, especially Asian food. You know, my friends and I, we'd come here, hang out, kill time, watch movie, and just pretty much like a very low-key chill spot. On a weekend or a Friday night or any particular, you know, statutory holiday, this plaza, especially during the summer, is packed.
More than 20 years on, this mall currently houses more than 150 stores, mostly independent mom-and-pop shops.
So from 2017 to 2019, I ran a Korean cafe, also serving dessert. Back then, in 2017, it was actually quite busy when we first opened. I would say towards, you know, 2019, you know, when we got more stabilized and more normalized, we did notice actually an increase in traffic. You know, with these bigger anchor tenants coming in, I think it's gonna, you know, keep increasing the traffic here and in business in general.
In recent years, more changes have been brought upon this plaza, which actually further solidifies its status as one of the city's premier Asian shopping destinations. What is right there, Omomo, presently used to be Golf Town. And right here, even though you can't really see anything, it's Go Place. It's one of the biggest Chinese spas, and that used to be a gigantic Cineplex Odeon.
So the Cineplex here, that used to be here, we used to go there a lot. This theater used to air a lot of Hong Kong films. So, you know, we'd go there and check out films there.
As is the case in many shopping plazas, constant turnover is the name of the game, especially for mom and pop owned businesses. However, there is one place in First Markham that has totally withstood the test of time. It's been in the same spot for more than 20 years, pretty much since the mall first opened. And that place serves up great Shanghainese dim sum and soup dumplings, Ding Tai Fung.
So we are a Chinese restaurant that specializes in Shanghainese dim sum, especially our xiaolong baos, our soup dumplings. Those are our most popular item here. We opened the store about 2 years after the plaza was first opened. So Shanghainese dim sum is a bit different from the Hong Kong style of dim sum, just because usually Hong Kong dim sum is in the morning or in the afternoon, but whereas we like to eat this more for lunch or dinner. So the plaza when we first opened was less busy. About half of the stores were open or starting to slowly open up. But now the plaza is very, very busy. Yeah, as soon as there's a store gone, there's another one that opens. So around the exterior of the plaza, it was a lot of food. However, inside the plaza has always been about the same. There's the food court, whereas there's a lot of commercial units inside the interior.
It's more of a community space for local residents to not only hang out, but you know, participate in various programs. They actually host events in the food court area, and that's when, you know, we would see a lot of community activities happening. Could be you know, after school programs. I've seen people perform here, and overall, it's a good community space for people to, you know, express their arts.
We believe that in the next few years, the plaza will definitely become still a very booming place. More stores that will probably open in the next few years. I believe the indoor mall as well. Sometimes they go through their renovations, their food court's always changing. Overall, it looks very uphill from here.
One thing seems to be for certain, and that is that change will continue to happen at First Markham, whether it be in the form of new restaurants coming from overseas or turnovers in some of the smaller mom and pop shops, change is always a constant. And personally, I am very interested to see what further developments awaits this mall.